Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new poem, that is Vocation. With this particular poem we are going to complete our part. So this poem Vocation is written by Rabindranath Tagore. Before I start explaining the poem, you need to know certain informations regarding Rabindranath Tagore. Though I know you all have much information about the Bard of Bengal, so Rabindranath Tagore, the Bard of Bengal, we call him Gurudev, Kavi Guru or Biswakavi, as you all know. So was born on 7th May 1861 and died on 7th August 1941. He was a Bengali polymath, poet, writer, playwright, composer, philosopher, social reformer, painter and what not. We Bengali, we cannot think beyond him. He controls our each and every emotion. He has taken care of our each and every emotion. And we find our heart to get composed, to get compassion in his poems as well as in his songs. So this particular poem, Vocation, it was written in 1900 and it was first published in 1909. So this is what I wanted to convey through this poem. You will come to know about a child's, probably in this particular poem you all will come to know, you all will get, rather you will be finding your own self. Yes, so here we will be finding that a child speaks about his wishes and his aspirations. We all are in the same condition. We are never satisfied with our present condition. We always seek for seek comfort in someone else's situation. The same thing is here echoed through a certain boy's voice. So let us continue with so here we will be finding that, as I told, that a child, his childhood aspiration and his seeking a comfort in someone else's zone. So let us start. I want each one of you to keep your book ready and keep a pen and paper ready with you so that you all can take necessary notes. So let's start. When the gong sounds 10 in the morning and I walk to school by a lane, every day I meet the hawker crying, "Bangles, crystal bangles." There is nothing to hurry him on. There is no road he must take, no place he must go to, no time when he must come home. I wish I were a hawker, spending my day in the road, crying, "Bangles, crystal bangles." So the first stanza says that when the gong sounds 10 in the morning, means it's the time when the child walks to his school, 10 in the morning, he finds a hawker selling bangles in his lane. Okay, the hawker was not in a hurry, and he used to move from one place to another at his own will. There is no compulsion. He, as the boy thinks, of course, so the hawker definitely has his compulsion. There are certain things, certain limitations he also has in his life, which is unknown to the boy. The boy finds him like a free bird who can roam around at his own will. And the boy thinks that the hawker could take any road and return home when he wants, since the boy is going to school and he is bound to get back to his home as per the schedule of the school. He is not allowed to come back home at any point of the day. So the boy finds that the hawker is quite happy, as he is not restricted by any sort of boundaries, and there is rather no restrictions on him as per the boy thinks. So the child wants to be a hawker in order to be free and happy as the hawker. So hawker is a person who sells things means in exchange of money, and he carries all those things along with him. So I hope first paragraph is quite clear to you. Here crystal bangles means glass bangles, transparent like glass. So I hope first paragraph is clear to you all. When at 4 in the afternoon I come back from the school, I can see through the gate of that house the gardener digging the ground. He does what he likes with his spade. He soils his clothes with dust. Nobody takes him to task if he gets baked in the sun or gets wet. I wish I were a gardener, digging away at the garden with nobody to stop me from digging. So here again the boy, he is somehow thinking when he returns back, when it gets dark in the evening, and he returns back in the afternoon, when he returns back from his school, he finds a gardener outside the house, outside one house. And the gardener, he generally uses to dig the ground with his spade, and his clothes become dirty with dust and soil, and there is nobody who is going to, as he works under the sun, there is nobody to stop him or to make him distracted from doing or to getting all those dust in his clothes. But the boy, he wants to be and that the boy finds, and he wants to be like him. He wants to be as free as him, as he finds that gardener also very much free, very much happy. Okay, and this is, and he wants to in this way he wants to pay to the soil. All right, now let us continue with the third and final paragraph, where we find that just as it gets dark in the evening and my mother sends me to bed, I can see through my open window the watchman walking up and down. The lane is dark and lonely, and the street lamp stands like a giant, one red eye in its head. The watchman swings his lantern and walks with his shadow at his side, and never once goes to bed in his life. I wish I were a watchman, walking the streets all night, chasing the shadows with my lantern. So here in the final paragraph we find that when it gets dark in the evening and the child's and the boy's mother sends him to bed and she orders him to sleep, the child finds a watchman through his window. He saw that watchman walking up and down, and the road on which the man treads on, it's dark, it's lonely, and nobody is present there to stop the watchman. So the watchman takes his lantern and he walks along with his own shadow. Thus, and the lantern here with him, it and the lamp of the street lamps, it stands like a giant with him and no one else. So the watchman, the boy wants to be a watchman, walking all throughout the night and all along the street without any restriction. So this is what we find in this poem Vacation. I hope this explanation will be helpful, and we have live class back to it. We can have a discussion on it if you cannot understand any part. This poem is written in a very simple way, very simple manner. Only we need to catch its rhythm, and somewhere we will definitely be finding our own selves. So this much for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.